Yeah, so I built... Okay, how far should I start? Okay, so I built this. Built a split plank, or lat split. Splank would be a better name. So it started from me looking at mechanical keyboards. I was working on a Poker 3, 60%, and I was hunting for a new keyboard. I actually looked at the ErgoDox, which is over there, and then I looked at the Arches, which is over there too, and then I decided that maybe for the best of both worlds is actually to build a split plank. Because I was deciding between a staggered column and an autolinear layout. So generally speaking, what I'll do is I'll go through like how I got about building it. I won't talk about the obsession and how much time I spent on Rated and Mass Drop. So we broke it up into parts. So to build this thing, there were mainly three parts. The first part would be the first part is getting the hardware made. So the hardware that needed to be made. So there's the faceplate and the baseplate. So those were laser cut. So I got mine laser cut out of stainless steel, which is a little bit tricky to find. It's easy to find laser cutters that will cut acrylic. But for acrylic, you would have to get something like 3mm acrylic instead of 1.5mm. Because 1.5mm, what generally will happen is that you'll start to warp. 3mm, it's thick enough. But then again, I'm quite happy with getting stainless steel as well, because it actually ends up being quite heavy. So there's the face and the base plates. The next thing to get is actually the PCBs. So I didn't do hand wiring, I actually got the PCBs from somewhere and got them printed. Except that later you find out that the PCBs were actually, there were flaws in the design. So okay, this is the first build. First build took me 12 hours to fix. The second build took me 3. Like software and hardware don't go very well together. So then there's getting the hardware, soldering it together, and then loading up the firmware. So firmware also has issues as well, so I'll go through them step by step. So, okay, I'm sure most people will be familiar with this place, right? Like keyboard layout editor. So this is the starting point. So this essentially is the basic layout for one side of the lat split. Because lat split essentially is two of the same PCBs. I mean, I brought up PCBs if I remembered, but I forgot. So essentially you just take the layout. You go into this place called this particular address. Yeah, plate and case builder. And you paste it in, you make adjustments if you want to, including H the padding, yay march, and if you wanted, put a sandwich, USB card mount, nope, number of holes, give me 4 please, diameter 2, I'll just throw in random numbers for now, because I don't know what I'm doing here. Required, H width is required, okay, 4.
Good.
Yeah. I mean, the next time around, I'll probably like do my own. Like, I'll probably make my own CAD drawing or vector drawing, because the amount of buffer that this particular online application actually gives you is actually very. It gives you way too much buffer for the bezel, so you end up with really decent bezels on the side. So actually, okay. So what happens is that you can take this. And you can actually send it to be cut here, LaserGist, which is these guys in Greece. They took 2 months. Of all the things, this was the first thing I ordered, and this was the last thing that came in. They took 2 months to come in. So half and half about using the same guys again. When they came in, it was great. No particular qualms there, had to file some edges off. So that's the plates, right? So those are the top, yep.
How much were those?
$78 for one set, if I'm right. Yeah, $78 for one set. Yeah, I think so. Let's get a quote now. We can get a quote now and then we would know. So, quantity, switch, open, bottom. So you need two of each on... It doesn't matter if it's brushed or shiny. And free white shipping, oh, there you go. I think my bezel was a little bit tighter and it managed to drop down to 78 USD. So for a set, it's about 78.
Yeah.
Including shipping.
Yeah,
I gotta change it. This is if I'm gonna build it again, this is the main part that I'll change. The next part is actually the PCBs. The PCBs are here actually online. So someone actually uploaded it and someone actually forgot to update the Gerber files. So I had to do some manual hacks. I'll go through the manual hacks later, but yeah, that's where part of my 12 hours came from. But you can get the Gerber files, and what you could do is actually you could send it to Seed Studio and you can add your Gerber files here. So for me, it was actually much cheaper to just print 10 pieces, so I just printed 10. I still have like 6 pieces unused, so if anyone wants them, I have them. Yeah. Okay, I'll pass it to you another day. Yeah. So these guys came out to be about, a couple of bucks each anyway. So these guys came out to be quite cheap. PCBs, generally speaking, are still quite cheap. And they're not big as well, so generally speaking, the prices are low. So in terms of the bill of materials, someone actually did go through the parts and actually did create a card for the bill of materials. So all you really need, apart from the switches, all you really need is the TRRS socket, which actually you don't really need TRRS, you just need TRS, you don't need the additional ring. You only need that. So TRRS is actually this, it's just this. Yeah, it's just the audio jack, right? So on your phone is a TRRS ring. So it has 4 inputs. A regular audio jack only has 3. Actually, you only need 3. You only need a TRS input. A TRS input. They have it, but in the Gerber design files, it's not connected to anything. Right. So it means nothing. I think they had plans for it to be, there were some parts in the firmware that they had plans for it to be hooked up on either side, but when I built it, I found that it actually wasn't hooked up to anything. So yeah, that's your bill of materials. The last piece I got was the Arduino. I got an Arduino Micro. I got itchy and I tried the 3.3 volts, which also led to more problems, which will come into a bit. But essentially everything I got from DigiKey. So for 3 sets of them, I've got essentially 3 sets of materials from DigiKey. I think it added up to about 200 sing. So thereabouts. Yeah. What else did I buy from DigiKey? Oh no, I bought some other stuff along the way, so maybe my estimates are not right. The most expensive parts were the Arduinos. Each piece is about 25 bucks in. You need 2 per keyboard. So you have both sides. The good thing about this is that technically, if I program it right, if I hook up to my machine from the right side, I can have a DOVEC layout, and I hook it up from the left side, I have a regular QWERTY layout. I don't do that shit yet, but you know, the option's there. So let's talk about the build first. So this is me trying out the keyboard. Yeah, it's so cute, it's so tiny. So that's the PCB. Not exactly a great shot. If I brought it, it'd be great. Essentially, you just wire in all the diodes. Make sure you wire in the diodes the right way. Something about doing hardware is that, because I do software, right? And software, yeah. Something I've learned about hardware is that you always check twice. You really don't want to take everything out and do it again. I did it once with this guy here. So I forgot to solder a diode underneath. So I had to take it out and then re-solder it. Yeah, that was not fun. So, yep. Not much there. Okay, so far so good. Everything was fine and dandy, easy soldering. Then got to testing, right? So solder everything in. At this point, it's about 2 hours in. 1.5 hours, 2 hours in. Not that far. Lights up. And then tested it. And what I found out was that on the right side, the middle row doesn't work. So HJKL doesn't work. Right? And I was like, what the fuck is going on? There's one more last one. 3D Gerber file. So you do what you do next, which is you go to a 3D Gerber viewer and you upload the Gerber files and you trace the copper. Because I was really sure it was not the hardware, the software anymore. So yeah, essentially it's something like this, right? Just as an example. Uploaded a Gerber file just to trace the copper, to trace where things were connecting. And this was kind of helpful. This was really kind of helpful because you can actually remove layers just to see where the copper is. And what I ended up doing was this. The copper that is connected to 8 is not connected, and the copper that's supposed to connect pin number 3 is supposed to connect pin number 4 to the TRS. This took me 3 hours. 3 hours to figure this shit out. Because, yeah, this is the deal with how. And this thing here as well. Like, you had to scratch off the copper because the copper doesn't make sense. So these two hardware hacks, they have been updated. They updated inside the Gerber file on GitHub. So hopefully the next time you download it, it'll be fine. So are you sure you still want the PCBs because you have to make these hacks?
I was going to ask you, did you just find it in the Gerber by viewing the thing, or did you use a multimeter to check?
Actually, I don't have a multimeter, so I did something super hacky. I just passed power through things.
Yeah.
That's how I got an inkling that something was wrong.
I believe that's how we roll.
Just passed power through everything. But then I had an inkling what was going on. Then there were two problems with the Gerber file itself. There were two problems with the PCB design itself, which was this two. Yeah, that was 3 hours. That was great. That was all fun. So, okay, at this point in time, right side works fine, left side works fine, except that on the right side, when I do Shift J, for example, things would not work. So, okay, at this point in time, check the Gerber files again, check the hardware, make sure nothing was wrong. And then, lo and behold, where are you? I see my pull request is still here. This.
Oh, nice.
So, honestly speaking, I have no idea what's going on here. I am completely just hacking my way through the firmware. So I'm using QMK firmware. So at this point in time, I really have no idea what I just changed, but I just changed it and it works. So I'm just gonna leave it as that. Hopefully someone knows better, like someone knows QMK firmware better than I do to actually make things work. So at this, yeah. Yeah, it's like I have no idea. So, had to make a pull request for this one, just in case someone stumbles upon the same problems as I do. Because everything inside the firmware repository is actually built for the Pro Micro 5 volts. And I want the Pro Micro 3.3 volts. So, go figure that shit out. So, yeah, all the pull requests are here. So, that's that. So this is my keyboard compared to the size of my monitors. That's a nicer shot of it. And last but not least, let's see. Yeah, okay, here. So this is me typing. This is me typing at the start when I just built the keyboard. This is how fast I typed. On the side note, it was like 11 in the morning after about a 12-hour stint. Yeah. So, yep, that's that. Cool.
A question for you.
Yes.
Is any two more commands for each keyboard? Did you actually end up using that, or were they four?
The second Arduino actually is a slave Arduino to the primary one. So the primary one actually just passes the power to the second one and it actually bypasses everything. Yeah, so but if you, that's what I'm saying, it's a bit of a waste. Like you actually do flash two ROMs on the keyboard. There's a left ROM and there's a right ROM. So so the ROM's very different from the firmware, the layout firmware itself. You flash the ROM, there's apparently a number of times you can flash the ROM. But you could flash the ROM saying that this is the right side and you want this layout, so you could have a COMAC layout on the right. So if you do plug a USB cable from the right, your keyboard will be a COMAC layout. I'm on a QWERTY, so on a QWERTY layout, if I connect the USB cable from the left side, it'll be QWERTY. So the idea is that I follow the instructions. I haven't toyed that much after that. Yeah, I mean, okay, I take it back. Yeah, I toyed a little bit, but after 12 hours, I didn't really want to try anything else. Yeah. So, yeah.
Did you try any of the interesting features on GeoPad?
I'm doing layers. So most things, okay. The main thing I did was, okay, there are some things. What's the one? Tap and hold. So I've replaced key, so cap locks. Okay, let's see if I can find my layout. Projects, side. Oh, here we are. Okay, this is mine. Give me a second, let me just double check. No, that's not mine. Try to see. Oops. No. I think I have it on my other machine, maybe. I'm not very sure. Or not. Wait. No, it's not on GitHub. No, this one I didn't think I kept it on GitHub. Maybe. Okay, yeah. No, it's not here. So the main thing I'm trying to look for the guy that I actually took reference to. It's actually this guy with seven layers on the plank. And the interesting part is one of his layers is actually for Braille. And yeah, so he has seven layers on his plank. It's a very symmetrical design. Like it's very symmetrical. Like he kept even brackets on the first layer. So left, these two keys are brackets, apparently. I couldn't do it, I need a shift. So I only have three layers. I only have base, upper and lower layer. I don't have that many, seven is crazy. I'll just check out everything. But generally speaking, the whole design is supposed to be relatively symmetrical that way. Blanks, great. Escape is here. So with most planks, escape is here. So the main feature I did use from QMK was tap and hold. So if I tap it, it's escape. If I hold it, it's function one. Yeah. So I could do things like the Vim mappings, the Vim mapping of up, down, left, right. So hold down left pinky on escape and HKJL. Yeah. So page up, page down above it and all stuff like that. So that's the main feature that I did take from QMK. The rest of it is really, really just layering the layouts. And then I found out that I think you can actually do MIDI stuff with it, so maybe I'll try that next.
You can do MIDI and you can actually play audio through a piezo speaker.
Yeah. So I mean, not so much about audio part but about the MIDI controller part. Yeah. Yeah, so I might try the MIDI controller part next.
No philosophy though.
I mean, I do have some MIDI controllers at home, so I don't mind playing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The machine. Well, even then
you've got
it. Yeah. Yeah. But it's nice in the sense that you can make it buzz whenever you press cap lock.
Oh, yeah.
So if you have a individual way of or if you switch layer without owning, you decide to switch layer, you can make it plus a different tone.
Okay, I didn't. Okay, I haven't tried that one yet. Okay.
So I initially I remove catalog in a new music.
Yep.
But there are some conditions that I just want it. Putting one key somewhere.
Yeah.
Just in case you press a mistake.
Okay.
I have to you. I know I press catalog.
Okay. Cool. Yeah. So yeah, that's it. I mean now this is my workforce now. I've made two so far. One at home and one at work. One I do bring around ever so often. But 40%. I don't understand these people who are doing 30% keyboards. Like I really don't know how it works. I think 40% is great. Like it's actually I had issues on the 60% whereby I couldn't find the symbols, especially when the symbols are still on the number row. It's impossible to find the symbols. On this it's easy because I've mapped symbols just like I've mapped my numbers, which is on opposing sides, just like the numpad. Right, so it's very easy to recognize. 30% people, I don't know. 30%.
Yeah, 40% is hard, but 30%.
It's like, I don't understand.
1% is, that's the way.
Escape buttons. Big red
one.
Yeah. So, yep, that's that. Yep. Okay, any more questions? Any more? More typing? More to the Elks? Anything else?
Would you do it again?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean.
What's your next project?
Frankly speaking, I think I'm done with keyboards. Like, I'm at end game, man. Okay, no, my next it's not true. I found out about these things called gray switches.
That's very great, yeah.
Yeah, I might try. Oh, no, it's 80. So I'm on green switches. Oh yeah, by the way, I'm on Gatron greens. So I might try a cherry gray, because I kind of like. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe that's the next one. Maybe I'll desolder everything. Maybe I'll just solder everything on this one and then replace it with the grays. I'm not very sure yet. Or maybe I'll just build a new one. Because that one seems like it's much easier than to desolder everything.
It's very easy to
do that. Yeah, but like my friend said, it's like, you know, like, what am I going to do with a top mountain of keyboards over there? It's like, I have two Focus sitting at home doing nothing right now. Anyone wants free Focus? Like, green switches? Just saying. Like, they are really underutilized right now.
Should I have a competition for the
Focus?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can have both if you want.
No, I don't want it. I think.
Well, you can organize it. I mean, I'll just donate it as a prize. Yeah.
Like a quiz or something.
Well, yeah.
We'll make sure a nice cake.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make a nice cake and get a Focus.
Sounds good. Yeah. I mean, green switches though. So, I there are folks with green switches over there, so I guess. Yeah, we're all the same like wavelength. I think in terms of keyboards, I think I really like this layout. I don't deny this. I really like this layout. The 40% plank. It covers pretty much all my use cases actually. Yeah, in fact, I actually find it a lot better than the 60% poker. I mean, apart from it being autolinear, right? Like, being able to find my symbols and my numbers is great. Because I was on blanks on the poker as well. And to find, symbols and numbers, especially key, like passwords and symbols and numbers. Like,
it's really programmable.
Yeah.
I mean, it's unprogrammable.
Yeah, semi-programmable. Yeah. So, the layout, and the fully programmable part really works in this case. Yeah.
How fast? So, we all saw the video of
how fast are typing now.
Yeah.
Okay. How
are you now? Like, how long have you
been adjusting? Well, it took me about. About a week to get used to it. I did try. I do have numbers for this. I'm about 60 words per minute now. So it's still okay, decent, can get by. Like, survivable, I guess. Yeah, also the other thing is actually you get a nicer case. I love in the prayer. Yeah. So generally speaking, compared to what I did last time, it's much. And okay, something about the author linear is that when you first start on it, your bad habits, all your bad habits show. For me, it was B, P, and O. Yeah, they all show. Yeah. Oh. Is it the same? Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm sure.
It was my C and B.
C and B, eh? Yeah. Actually, I got follow C and B as well. Yeah. Yeah.
You just see too much, see more than me, bro.
Yeah.
C is somewhere really awkward. I was thinking about changing the place. I got my choice two weeks ago, and it's my, like, I told Tony, like, it was my first ortho linear, first chair switch, first ergonomic keyboard, yeah. And it has the blank keys. So it's really hard for me to get used to it.
Yeah. I think, yeah, the black, that, something I've learned after building these things is that your is malleable. Like, your ability to type is very malleable, and then that's what I appreciated about it. So I like to answer the question, like, even though it was about a week, I didn't think it was too long as well. Like, it took me about a week to be productive, but it sounds like a lot, but it's not a lot. And frankly speaking, I wouldn't look back as well. And because, okay, longest story is I was deciding between the Poker and the Leopold FC 660. Yeah, so because I didn't want to get rid of the arrow keys, right? So I was like, okay, never mind, I shall learn to touch type and I shall try to do it, you know, the Vim way. So that took about a week or to learn as well. And once you learn that, I was like, okay, I can go to the Poker now. I don't have to worry about Leopold. And I look back as well, because like, now the arrow keys are too far away. Yeah, then you move to the Ortholinias and you find that actually, yeah, there are bad habits and you get annoyed ever so often. But you learn that after these repeated tries, you learn that it's actually your skill set, your typing skills are actually very malleable. Or rather, your brain in general is actually very malleable. Yeah, so, yeah, I mean, it's about a week. I mean, generally speaking, it is about a week. But yeah, I wouldn't look back on that as well. Yeah.
From start to finish, yes. Like, how much would one cost? Like, if you were to just make it, like, how much would one keyboard cost?
I think it's just short of 200.
Okay.
Yeah, just short of 200. Including the most expensive parts are the plates. Find a better place to cut plates. I mean, yeah, but
the variables are pretty expensive, and the switches as well.
Switches are actually all right. 48 switches, Mass Drop has a drop, but you don't have to go to Mass Drop for Gatron switches. There's a guy on eBay. Seinin, I think.
Oh, Seinin just checked as well.
Yeah?
Yeah, he just did a good buy for Grace. Actually.
Yeah.
Which, yeah.
So, Seinin 30.
It's S-E-N-N-I-N 32, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah. 32 or 23 or something like that. Oh, there we are. Yeah, so he sells the Gatrons, I mean, he sells the switches at the same price as Mass Drop drops. So, pretty decent price.
If you can handle Chinese, do it
or yeah. How yeah.
Smash,
I know.
Get
Taobao, man. I don't know about Taobao. I'm still half and half about that. Like, in terms of quality. Oh, is that right?
Yeah, like the Apple standard.
Okay. Okay.
They use on separate apps. Like that they sell it from
one. What's the failure rate for it? As in the switches. Like, do you have to replace any of the switches?
No.
Do you have to toss any of the switches out?
Get one to the fine
switch. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I should try that. Yeah, I've been half and half about Taobao for the longest time.
I mean, like, yeah. there was a thread on Reddit with the Discord link, which led to Google Docs with all the things. So
yeah.
All of us on the Discord have used those links. Like,
okay.
That's why we put them there. Like,
okay. Okay.
Legit.
Yeah.
Okay. And they have a better success rate than mob switches.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah. It's cool. Yeah. So yeah, to answer your question. Yeah.
Well, are there times you wish the keyboard wasn't speak?
What's what?
Are there times when you wish the keyboard was not speaking?
Oh, no, that's fine. No, 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 no at all. Like, what's going to suppose a fiddle like that? I mean, there was a mod with it that actually you can put like magnetic connectors as well.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, the problem with this is that bezel is actually pretty thick. So there were times that I wished that the padding and the bezel was a bit slimmer. But that I'll deal with another time. But worst comes to worst, I just put it together and it just works fine. Yeah. Plus, I work on a massive mouse pad, so they don't slip around that much either, so it's great. Yeah. In fact, yeah. Like, I don't know, I don't dare say I'm an endgame anymore. But I feel pretty comfortable with this set of keyboards. Yeah.